Well now, we call this the act of mating. But there are several other very important differences between human beings and animals that you should know about.
Two. Is that coming through?
Yeah.
One.
Yeah. Yeah.
One, two. One, 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 one. One, two. One. 1, 2, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. One, two. I couldn't really hear it out there. One, two.
Crazy. There's no way that you can save me. It's a can't go with him, Haley. Nowadays, everybody wanna talk like they got something to say. But nothing comes out when they move their lips. Just a bunch of gibberish. And motherfuckers act like they forgot about grace. Nowadays, everybody wanna talk like they got something to say. But nothing comes out when they move their lips. Just a bunch of gibberish. And motherfuckers act like they forgot about grace.
Do something to me, you motherfuckers. Stop coming up to me with your hands out, looking up to me like you want something free. When my last CD was out, you wasn't bumping me. But now that I got you no company, everybody wanna come to me like it was some disease. But you won't get a crumb from me, cause I'm from the streets of. I told them all the little gangsters, who you think helped mold them all? Now you wanna run around talking about guns like I ain't got none. What you think, I sold them all? Cause I stay well off. Now all I get is hate mail all day saying Dre fell off. What? Cause I've been in the lab with a pin in the pad trying to get this damn label off. I ain't having that. This is the millennium of aftermath. It ain't gonna be nothing after that. So give me one more platinum plaque and fuck rap. You can have it back. So where's all the mad rappers at? It's like a jungle in the habitat. With all you savage cats, know that I was strapped with gas when you were cuddling the cabbage patch.
Nowadays, everybody wanna talk like they got something to say. But nothing comes out when they move their lips. Just a bunch of gibberish. And motherfuckers act like they forgot about grace. Nowadays, everybody wanna talk like they got something to say. But nothing comes out when they move their lips. Just a bunch of gibberish. And motherfuckers act like they forgot about grace. Nowadays, everybody wanna talk like they got something to say. But nothing comes out when they move their lips. Just a bunch of gibberish. And motherfuckers act like they forgot about grace.
Ladies and gentlemen, a delay in our show today. We will be starting shortly in approximately 10 minutes time. Thank you.
Truth is, I thought it mattered. I thought that music mattered. But does it bollocks? not compare to how people matter.
Ladies and gentlemen, our show will be starting in about 10 minutes' time. We apologize for the delay. This is due to traffic. So we'll be starting shortly. Thank you.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, our apologies for the delay in our show tonight. This is due to traffic, but our show should be starting shortly. A big thank you, though, to all of our sponsors here this evening, including our main sponsor, Damien Walton from Amelcor Technologies. We're extremely grateful for all of the support from also from Bill Kirbishley of Teenage Cancer Trust and Trinfield Music. A big thank you as well to Tony Richards, Harry Cowlip, a professional boxer, 21 fights, 4 titles, runs as light heavyweight, Terry Gallagher and Lee Harris. This 4 gentlemen gifted a considerable amount of money to help us continue with this show this afternoon and provide boxers an opportunity to showcase themselves here at Peacock Gyms. And their big company, thank you again to Access Scaffolding and Schaefering. Big thank you as well to Andy Harris of My Life, Frank Warren of Queensbury Boxing, Peter Waddley of Big Motoring World, and Andrew Lang of AC Roofing PLC. So ladies and gentlemen, thank you again for your support and your patience. Our show will begin shortly. Thank you. Approximately 10 minutes away, so we'll begin our show in approximately 10 minutes. Thank you.
Yeah! Sometimes I wish to run away. Sometimes I want to run away. But you can't judge a book from looking at the cover. You can't love someone from messing with another. No, you can't win a war fighting with your brother.
Now you can't get.
Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, a big warm welcome to the Peacock Gym here in Canning Town, London, for this afternoon's show. We apologize as well for the delay in starting our show, but everything is ready for us to begin the show. So ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, are you ready? I can't hear you, London. Are you ready? Then, ladies and gentlemen, our first bout of the evening, please welcome first into the ring and to the red corner, Maria Safakovic. Her opponent, ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, please welcome into the arena and to the blue corner, T. Allen. Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, your opening bout of the afternoon. Brought to you, Peacock Promotions, brought to you in association with TM Promotions. Proudly prepared six rounds of action in the welterweight division. This bout has been sanctioned by the British Boxing Board of Control, our supervisor here at ringside, Mr. Des Reese. Our timekeeper at the bell, Mr. Mark Shannon, and our referee scoring the action inside the ring, Mr. Sean McAvoy. So introducing first, boxing out of the red corner, her official weight on the scales, 147.2 pounds. She enters the ring today with a record, one victory, 13 defeats, one draw, wearing the black and white shorts from Serbia, presenting Maria Safakovic. Her opponent tonight, standing across the ring and boxing out of the blue corner. Her official weight on the scales, 147.2 pounds. She enters the ring tonight as a perfect professional record. Four victories, three coming by
knockout, wearing the blue, black, and yellow shorts from Leytonstone, London, presenting Dee Allen. Our referee to give his final instructions.
Okay, it's a six-round contest. Get your feet at all times, protect yourselves at all times. Touch gloves, here we go. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck.
Good luck.
Good fight. Hopefully, you guys are still for it. Hope so.
Sections out. Round one.
So we've got Alan fighting out of the blue corner. Zikovic fighting out of the red corner. Welcome back, everybody.
Yes, welcome back to the standing room only. It's a six round contest. Six twos.
Six 2 minute rounds. The boys are sounding a bit sore. You had a good night last night.
Yeah, I was out supporting the boys yesterday, Chris and Ellis. And I got to pay the price for it today. Alan's done some good shots. Just applying the pressure on Zikovic. Zikovic is on the back foot. Good punch selection, good combination of shots. He's pulling them together well.
Trapped Zikovic in the corner there. Zikovic.
Yeah. And she's not rushing her work knee, but she's not rushing in and, you know, being in a position where Zikovic can hold her. She's, you know, keeping her distance and setting everything up with a jab, which is nice to see.
Feels really short a 2 minute round, don't it?
Yeah,
it feels
a bit too
short. Get into gear, yeah. First round out. Give that to Alan, that round.
Seconds out, round two.
Good to see Johnny Greaves here. He's had over 100 fights. He's here with Lee Hallett today, I'm sure the other boxers.
Yeah, Johnny Greaves. Zikovic is just packing up into the corner and waiting too long, not letting his shots go. I think she's felt, you know, Alan's power and feels like it's a bit dangerous to open up.
Yeah, and you can see Alan's, she's got good boxing IQ as well. So.
Yeah, most definitely. Not rushing her work, nice and patient. Like I said before, everything off the jab.
Come on, pop, pop.
Oh, good right hand by Alan. Oh, and a good right to the body. Screenshot as well.
Yeah. It's like every punch he throws comes from a different angle.
Yeah, exactly, yeah. It'd be hard for Zygofitch to read. Oh, good right hand. Good right hand from Alan, all right on the bell. Same kind of bell, that was a good shot. Take that shot.
Yeah, I was about to say she's got a chin.
She's got a chin in her.
Jabs through her guard.
Right? Yeah, literally, she punched it through the guard, yeah.
Massive thanks to some of the sponsors. Andy Harris of My Life, Frank Warren of Queensbury. Big motoring world, so
corners, 10 seconds.
Drivers out there, yeah. Check out big motoring world.
Seconds out, round four.
Get yourself down to standing room only.
Come on.
This is round four of a six round bout.
Good shot, well done, good. And again, you'll get every time. Every time she comes close.
That was a strong jab from Alan there.
Yeah, she's very powerful, she has a lot of power. Good right hook there.
Still can't get used to these 2 minute rounds.
Yeah, too short.
Like, I hear the 10 second click.
Yeah.
Oh, like, well, that just started. Big thanks to Andrew Lang from AC Roofing, TLC. Go and check them out, get your leaks fixed, because summer won't last long and it'll be raining again. That knockout.
Yeah, and I think she can get it. I think she can push for it.
Yeah, definitely. Zikovic just wants to make it to the end of the sixth. That's... She's done well to stay standing then, though.
Oh,
she's looked dazed a couple of times. But
yeah, she has. And she does well to recover.
Yeah.
I think if this was a 3 minute round, Alan would have got her out of there eventually.
Yeah.
Because every time she has a hook, yeah, the bell goes and then she has time to recover.
Yeah. massive congratulations to Ellis yesterday on his win.
Yeah, definitely.
And Chris Bjork, of course.
Yeah,
nice. So what was it like yesterday?
For the boys. Good atmosphere.
Good atmosphere?
Yeah, two wins. No, can't go wrong with that. You can tell with my voice. I enjoyed every moment of it. Both facts.
Screaming at the top of your lungs.
Corners, 10 seconds. Seconds out, six, and five grand.
Again, apologies for the MC's mic. I have to teach him how to hold it properly. No, I'm joking, no.
Oh, good right hand there.
Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, after six rounds of action, we go to our referee scorecard. Referee Sean McAvoy scores the contest 60-54 for your winner, D. Allen! Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, at this time, I would ask you and pray silent as we remember Steve Hisser, who died yesterday at the age of 83. He was well-known and well-loved in the boxing community, trained many amateurs, including Matthew Farewell, Ted Cheeseman, Daniel Deborah, Denzel Bentley, and many more. Working out of Fisher ABC, we will remember him with the 10 bell salute now, and we will also remember a well-known former boxer, Eric Guy. So ladies and gentlemen, please silence for the 10 bell. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, a big thank you to all of our sponsors again, and particularly a big sponsor, Damien Walton from Almelco Technologies. We thank them for sponsoring and giving boxers opportunity to step onto this stage today and to make a name for themselves. A big thank you as well to Carl Wayman of Lee Barton, Eric Haynes, RDM Limited, Michael and Robert Kelsey of Infinity Homes as well. A big thank you as well to Peter Bruce of PJB, David Forske of Copying and Joyce, and John Ward of Ward Glass. Now, ladies and gentlemen, this time I'd like to invite a few boxers here into the ring for you to meet. I'd like to share the ring with a few of these guys and definitely not go toe-to-toe with them. So please welcome into the ring Denzel Bentley, Dan Azir, Ellis Zorro, and Chris Balls. Ladies and gentlemen, please give him a big round of applause. So ladies and gentlemen, if you were watching PT Sport last night, you would have seen this man go toe-to-toe in a fantastic bout. Chris, oh, Tan, sorry, Chris is there. Come on, let's get in the picture, give Tan a big round of applause as well. So I'm going to give the mic and hand it over to Ellis to talk us. Chris, where's Ellis? Jesus Christ, oh man, is here today. Here you go. I'm going to hand it over to that with that shiny belt that you've got there from last night as well. So how do you get on? How did you feel winning the belt last night? How was the fight for you? I'm going to give the mic to you and let you carry on.
I've been waiting for a title for a long time now, since I was at 9-0. So it was good for me to get my first title. I won the box off in the summer on Sky Sports. And since then, yeah, we've been hunting down a title, so I'm happy to have this belt now, WBO European. It was a good fight, tricky at times, but I was happy to get the stoppage in the seventh round.
Seventh round stoppage with a hell of a knockdown as well. Brilliant fight to watch last night. What a wonderful way of finishing to pick up, as you say, the European WBO Championship as well. Obviously, don't want to say what's going to happen next, because we don't know quite yet, but we're going to talk to the team, I'm guessing, back home and find out exactly what's what. What would you like? What's the ambition that you'd like to see yourself going for?
nutshell, I'd say more titles, more big fights to headline more shows. Eventually, I'd like to fight for the British. Obviously, that's a big dream of mine, like the British title. But I leave that all to Martin Bowers, my manager.
Good man, good man. I'm sure we'll see more on that world stage as we step up. And yes, we'd like to see that British fight as well. We thought get that made with the team, definitely. Chris, you look like you've been through one. So I was looking at Chris, and I was actually going to pass over back. There's four of you here and only one of me, all right? So I might look slightly outnumbered as it goes. But you've been through the mill recently. Tell us all about it.
Yeah, you know, my face shows the battle scars at a tough six-rounder yesterday. But yeah, feeling good. It was good to get the rounds in. I boxed a few months before that and only went three rounds, so there's six good battle rounds for me.
Again, six rounds in the bank, locked down, ready to go. Looking, pushing to the 10 rounders and the 12s for the championships. So what's next for you?
Yeah, you know, I've already done 10s and 12s. These have just been sort of warm-up fights, trying to get me in line for them British and Commonwealth titles again. So the sooner the better for me, really. But yeah, let's leave it to my team and just as soon as possible.
As soon as possible. I'm sure we'll see and hear all about it on the platforms. And of course, if you want to follow them on Facebook, Instagram, go and follow them. They'll tell you what theirs are in a second. But let's come on to a British champion. Let's talk to Denzel in the middle there. Let's see, how's it going? What's happening with you at the moment?
Well, I haven't got much of a voice. Sorry, I was out supporting these two last night. So, yeah, to see how that went. But yeah, I'm just waiting for a new day. I'm hoping to push on back to world level. Hopefully by the end of the year or early next year. So that's my plan, just keep pushing to get back to that world title level.
In your mind, you're ready by the end of this year? Or are we talking a little bit more? What can we expect? When can we expect to see you back in the ring? That's the important thing that everyone, all the fans, want to see.
We're still waiting, you know, for a few days, but I'll be out two more times before the year's out, so that's a good thing. But if one of those can be a world title fight, I'll be happy. If not, then we, you know, wait for the opportunity next year.
That sounds like a game plan. I like that. Fantastic. Well, thank you very much. And we'll come to Dan last as well. Dan, how's it going for things with you? What's going on at the moment with you? What can we expect? We've seen you recently, so I'm guessing not for a month or so. Perhaps less. I'm just going to let you talk.
Yeah, thanks. First of all, before I say anything, I just wanted to mention how proud I am to have like these lot here, and you know, I'm really like blessed to be around a bunch of really good boxers. To start off with, Ellis is he's a lot younger than me. He was in the same class as my little sister. He was tiny, like really small little kid. He had his braids, pretty boy. And like just to see him standing beside me, he's a cruiserweight now, he's huge. Beautiful knockout yesterday, I'm just mad proud. And yeah, like I'm just really, really proud to be around these guys. Dental as well, I remember when I first came to the Peacock. He used to moan, oh, I'm not getting my opportunity, you know, I want to fight for a southern area. And then straight away, he fought for British, won it before even I did. You know, went all the way to Vegas for the world title, put on a beautiful show. And yeah, man, he's where he is now. He's one of the top leading contenders. Chris Bork, I remember him from the amateurs. Was it Ballam ABC? You know, he was one of the most talented there, and still is the most talented, one of the most talented around. But you know, he just did really good as an amateur. I'm just happy, sorry, I know I'm rambling, but these guys, they started off from, like, not nothing, but, you know what I mean? They really worked their way up, and I'm just so proud. We're all in a good place. So yeah, man, please give them a round of applause again for me, buddy. As for me, I'm just defending my European, so hopefully I might get another defense. Really, I'm just trying to mix it up with any of the top boys in Britain. Top five, whatever, just putting a good show for you guys, man. And that's what it's about, entertainment. I'm putting on a show for you guys. So yeah, man, thank you.
Thank you, Dan, thank you. Well, there's lots to come, I'm sure, from these four, and I'm sure everyone here at the Peacock will be supporting you and cheering you on as we see your next steps. So we really do look forward to seeing you all back on that right level that you should be on the world stage, working hard and winning championships. So, ladies and gentlemen, let's give it up one more time for Daniel Bradley, Dan Astier, Alice Sorrow, and Chris Ball. Typical Dan trying to get in on the gold.
Going nowhere, we ain't going nowhere. driving blind. Reckless, ignoring the warning signs. Reckless, just to arrive on time when you're far behind. Why was time designed? And where will time take me? Who's to say? Case of raw, playing bass guitar in a wasted bar to a crowd of five. When two of them are brothers and they told me doing covers, no, that's not me. Some human jukebox for you to play. Well, it's not yet, but who's to say where this life might lead? When I find my peace, who my wife might be. Until it's time to see. We don't know. We'll be right back.
application officially stuck, releasing the gifts we go. I'm keeping it real, ain't got a deal, but we're doing stills because we feel they know that we're keeping it gritty. Got the keys to the city, we're always preaching the dishes and code. Oh, my town's calling, my town's a show. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, our apologies for the delay, and we are back with more boxing action now. So ladies and gentlemen, please welcome first into the arena and to the corner, Jordan Krana! Opponent, ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, please welcome into the ring of the blue corner, P.A. Corder. Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, your next bout of the evening, brought to you in association with Warren Dutton of Telios Formula One and Ricky Ordizzo of Vesta Constructions. So Peacock Promotions in association with TM14 Promotions. Proudly present four rounds of action in the middleweight division. The bout sanctioned by the British Boxing Board of Control, our supervisor here at ringside, Des Reed, our timekeeper at the bell, Mr. Mark Shannon, and our referee in charge of the action, scoring the bout, Mr. Lee Emery. So introducing first, boxing out of the red corner, his official weight on the scales, 167 pounds. He is an experienced fighter wearing the black and gold shorts from Islington, London, presenting Jordan Krana. His opponent this afternoon, boxing out of the blue corner. His official weight on the scales, 163.5 pounds. He enters the ring with a perfect professional record. One victory coming by knockout, wearing the black and white shorts, presenting P.A. Gordon.
Apologies to everyone online for the delay, but we're back now. Standing in the standing room only.
Thanks for holding on.
Got Paul Gordon and Jordan Granham. Jordan Granham, sorry. This should be a good one.
All the local shops did well out of that break there.
Yeah, it needed a little killing.
I hope they appreciate that.
Seconds out, round one.
Must be hard though, after the wait. Have you had a fight delayed before and when you're ready?
Not delayed, but I've been afloat. Which is pretty, probably as annoying as having to wait. Because you don't know when you're on. So you're warming up, cooling down, warming up, cooling down.
Yeah.
And you might end up after the main event. Some good jabs there from Paul Gordon. Now a stable mate of ours at the Peacock Gym. Jordan Venom, you know, a good boxer himself. Throw some good shots. I don't think he's been stopped, or if he has, he's rarely been stopped.
Oh, strong with a jab.
Yeah.
He's not giving Granham a chance to
settle.
To find his rhythm. Yeah.
Yeah. Gordon covered it though.
Oh, good one too, yeah.
Oh, good shot there.
Body shot.
Good combination to set up as well.
Oh.
good jab there from Graham. Another good body shot from Gordon. Good double jab and a jab to the body. It's at, the fight's at a nice pace, it's not rushed, but they're both letting off good shots. So it was good for both fighters, probably both thinking about the shots they want to throw as well. Ooh. Yeah, Gordon's thrown some nice body shots. I like the work to the body from him. And there's another one again. He just sort of taps the 1-2 to the head and goes straight down. Kind of sets it up.
It's a middleweight bout for anyone that's tuned in. 4 3-minute rounds. Second bout of the night. Nice jab there.
Seconds out, round two.
Gordon's using his jab well, he's doubling it up, tripling it up, throwing it single, then doubling it up again, and then going straight down to the body. I like the variation of shots he's throwing.
Yeah, he's consistent with it. He's found his rhythm quick, hasn't he? Yeah.
He's got nice covers.
And he's using his space in the ring well. He's not just trying to take control from the centre.
Yeah, exactly. He'd be going backwards and he's throwing his jab, he's letting his shots go. Coming forward, he's still letting his shots go. He gets them hands back up nice and high. Good job, Devon Gunner. who needs to start thinking about his defence again after he gets his shot score. I think he just got a bit too comfortable there and just, yeah, you know, started throwing shots and forgot his defence.
Yeah, he's landing a few, but he's getting caught as well, isn't he?
So. Yeah.
Nice camera work from Wayne Maynard there.
Both fighters are getting a bit closer this round. Seeing them getting to the clinch a little bit. Turning into a little more of a fight than a box off as it was in the first two rounds. Good jabs there. And a backhand from Gordon. Oh, that was a good right hand from Gordon. Granham just kind of walked onto it as he was trying to let his hands go. Good right hand to the body again. Good right hand.
He's got good footwork, Gordon.
Yeah, he does.
Anytime Granham's throwing a feint, he's 2 meters away. Yeah, he's gone. Yeah.
He's out of there. He's in and out of trouble.
Glad we can hear the fighting now. So first event we did.
Couldn't really hear the punches.
Good round there.
Everybody to the wild, wild.
seconds.
Get your eardrum like a slug to your chest. Back a vest for your jimmy in the city.
Seconds out. Fourth and final round.
Fourth and final round here. Who have you got so far, Dems?
I got Gordon doing a bit of work. He's letting his jab go off nicely. And, you know, comes with a nice combination up top and then drops down to the body. So, I've got Gordon winning this.
He knows he's got to pull out the stops this round, hasn't he?
Yeah, yeah. Oh, good body shot from Gordon and a good left foot return from Brennan. Yeah, he needs to think about what's coming back. Sometimes you get too greedy, too comfortable, you just start chasing all the shots. Chesson's about to say some good shots from Gordon. He gets caught with a right hand.
Well, he's shown he's got a chin.
Yeah, definitely. And, definitely got a chin. I'll give him that. He's got good work rate as well.
Yeah. His endurance. He ain't getting tired. He's still throwing punches constantly.
Good fight, yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, after four rounds of action, we go to the referee's scorecard. Our referee, Mr. Lee Every, scores the contest 39-37 for your winner, P.A. Gordon!
I know what
Big thank you to our sponsors again, Harry Smith Architects, Arctic Constructions, David, Sharon, Bill and Stephen Jacob from the Wollaston Manor Golf Club and Country Club here with us at Ringside as well. So ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, our next panel of the evening. Please welcome first into the arena and to the red corner, Lee Halley. Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, please welcome into the arena, to the blue corner, Ollie Duffy! Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, our next panel of the evening, Peacock Boxing in association with TM14, proudly present four rounds of action in the Super Lightweight Division. The bout sanctioned by the British Boxing Board of Control, our supervisor here at ringside, Des Rees, our timekeeper at the bell for this bout, Mr. Mark Shannon, and our referee in charge of the action scoring the bout, Mr. Sean McAvoy. So introducing to you first, boxing out of the red corner, his official weight on the scales, 142.2 pounds, an experienced fighter wearing the black, gold and green shorts from Canning Town, London, presenting Lee Hallett. His opponent tonight, standing across the ring and boxing out of the blue corner, his official weight on the scales, 142.9 pounds. He enters the ring with a perfect professional record, 4 victories, no defeats, 1 coming by way of knockout. Wearing the white, red and blue shorts from Luton, presenting Ollie. One coming by way of knockout, wearing the white, red, and blue shorts from Luton, presenting Ollie Duffy. Our referee to give his final instructions.
Seconds out, round one.
Here we go, Lee Hallett. Johnny Greaves in his corner. Over 100 fights, Johnny Greaves.
Jeez. Yeah.
Legend, I think he said he's been coming Peacock since he was 12 or something.
Second set. Yeah.
Don't give away his age.
But yeah, Peacock's been around for a long time.
Here you go, Lee Hallett. Johnny Greaves in his corner. Over 100 fights, Johnny Greaves.
Jeez.
Yeah. Legend, I think he said he's been coming
Peacock. Yeah, his opponent, Ollie Duffy, in the white, red, and blue. I'm not sure what this is for him.
He's been around for a long time.
But he has come down the gym to spar, do a few rounds with Aaron Prosper, who's fighting for Southern Area Title Eliminator. And yeah, his opponent, he's quite Ollie Duffy, in the white, red and blue. Done a lot of his training out in Ghana. I'm not sure what in the Bookham gym. But he has come down the gym to spar, do a few rounds with Aaron Prosper, who's fighting for
voice.
He didn't do me any justice.
Yeah, too many words.
I'm gonna leave it to Lewis.
And he's 4-0, and Ollie Duffy.
Oh, there we go.
Thank God for Google.
Done a lot of his training in Ghana. In the Bookham gym. Heavy-handed as well. I'm not sure how many stoppages he's got in his record, but he didn't do me any justice.
Yeah, too many words.
I'm gonna leave it to Lewis.
Yeah, he's 4-0, Ollie Duffy.
Oh, there we go.
Thank God for Google. One KO for his dad.
Yeah, that probably doesn't tell the story.
Better than none.
Yeah, better.
I like to say
heavy handed
fights,
as well. I'm not sure how many times he's got in the real combat. You might have seen the gym, he's quite heavy handed. Lee Hallett doesn't get stopped much.
One if he doesn't get stopped,
I'm not sure. Yeah, that probably doesn't tell the story.
Better than none. I like to say four fights.
Lee Hallett doesn't get stopped much. If he doesn't get stopped, I'm not sure.
He's been he's been knocked out twice, Lee Hallett. He had a prosperous career, 64 fights.
Yeah, so it might be, you know, a bit tricky for Duffy to stop him, but if he does, he's making a statement, I guess.
He's had two, he's been knocked out twice, Lee Hallett. He's had a prosperous career.
It's a good one, two down the pipe. Oh, and a good left hook. Just as, you know, Hallett came jumping in. Yeah, so it might be, you know, a bit tricky for Duffy.
Good round for Duffy.
To stop him, but if he does, he's still going, I guess. Oh, and a good left hook. Just as, you know, Hallett came jumping in. Good round for Duffy.
While they punch each other in the face. Referee having a little word with them both. They're southpaw. They keep treading on each other's feet, don't they? While they punch each other in the face. If you're watching this from home, get involved in the chat on the YouTube. Let us know what you think. No criticism, please. Only compliments. And we know Denzel could talk more, but his voice is a bit worn from last night.
Yeah, you've got to blame it. Ellis Zorro and Chris Bolt
for watching
that.
This from home, get involved in the chat on the YouTube. Let us know what you think. No criticism, please. Only compliments. And we know Denzel could talk more, but his voice is a bit worn from last night.
Yeah, you've got to blame it. Ellis Zorro and Chris Bolt for that. Good shot selection there from Duffy. He just threw a couple there with his left hand, couple hooks, head and body. I like the variation. Good shot selection. SWS Boxing, thank you. See your comment. Left hand, appreciate it. Hooks, head and body.
I don't know, I feel a bit left out there though. Don't know if I agree with you. You are a legend, you are.
Oh, good left hook, guys, coming in. Thank you.
Takes on a no one, so.
SWS Boxing, thank you. See your comment, appreciate it.
don't know, I feel a bit left out there though. Don't know if I agree with it. Got good head movement, had it. So,
yeah,
constantly moving.
He's a sharp, so I can imagine how awkward he is.
No one, so,
for most of his opponents. But Duffy ain't rushing, I haven't seen him miss too many shots. Will be while he's been quite precise. He's shown a good shot selection. That was a good left hand to the body there, right before the bell.
Constantly moving. He's being patient with him. He ain't letting anything go.
He ain't rushing for most of his opponents.
Denzel, you've had a request here, mate. Let the punk talk. No. He said his baby's 6 days late. You've got to tell her to hurry up.
Terry, listen here. 6 days late, hurry up. Your parents are stressing. They want to meet you. Yeah.
Denzel, you've had a request here, mate. Let the punk talk. No. He said his baby's 6 days late. You've got to tell her to hurry up.
Terry, listen here, 6 days later, hurry up, your parents are stressing. He's trying to apply the pressure now. He's trying to sit on Duffy's chest and just throw some shots to the body. See how Duffy responds to that. I mean, he's still quite composed, he's still quite, you know, relaxed. That's a good right hand there from Duffy. He's trying to apply the pressure now. He's trying to sit on Duffy's chest and just throw some shots to the body. See how Duffy responds to that. I mean, he's still quite composed and he's still quite, you know, relaxed. That's a good right hand there, shots from Duffy.
Nice jab there.
Yeah, that's a good jab from Duffy.
Hell, it shook that one off then.
He did. He just doesn't stand still. He's always moving his head, always moving his feet. You know what I mean? He's never in one place. It's a good left hook there from Duffy.
Oh, good jab there from Hallett. Good return from Hallett, yeah. Hell, it shook that one off then.
He did. He just doesn't stand still. He's always moving his head, moving his feet, you know what I mean? He's never on the
left. Nice body shot there. Good return from Hallett.
Yeah.
He got out of the way from the return as well.
Yep, which is good.
What, the squatting?
Yeah, showmanship, from Lee Hallett.
Nice body shot there. I don't know what he was trying to prove with the squat, but he got out of the way from the return as well.
Yeah, which is good.
What, the squat?
Yeah, showmanship, Lee Hallett.
I don't know what he was trying to prove with the squat, but...
Yeah.
congratulations, by the way, for getting the punk tool.
Oh yeah, definitely, congratulations.
So if the boy, I'm guessing you're going to call it Denzel then.
Second half, fourth and final round.
Oh, congratulations, by the way, for getting the punk tool.
Oh yeah, definitely, congratulations.
I'll
take that.
I've been looking for them sweets.
I found a few.
So I've got 80 over this year.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Mine hit me. Yeah, I've got them. Last year was bad. Lee Hallett just trying to make it rough.
Yeah, good.
Jeez.
Good scrap this one.
It is a good scrap. Is Lee Hallett just hitting as the ref said breaks or Duffy gave him one back? Why not? Yeah. Why not? Good shot. Lee Hallett just trying to make it rough.
Yeah, good.
Jeez.
Good scrap this one.
It is a good scrap. Is Lee Hallett just hitting as the ref said breaks or Duffy gave him one back? Why not?
Lee Hallett's a local boy. He could literally walk from here after this.
If he's not too sore.
Yeah. Boy, he could literally walk from here after this.
If he's not too sore. Lee Hallett's thrown he's landed a couple clean left hands. Duffy's taking a while. Good fight, good scrap. Lee Hallett just turned it on right there at the end. But yeah, I'd give that to Duffy.
It was a good fight, close call though.
Yeah.
Oh, you've been on his podcast.
Lee Hallett's thrown he's landed a couple clean left hands. Duffy's taking a while. Good fight, good scrap. Lee Hallett just turned it on right there at the end.
It was a good fight, close call though.
Yeah.
Oh, you've been on his podcast, Let the Punk Talk.
Oh, have
I? You were telling me earlier, your favourite podcast.
Yeah, it was.
I have to check that out.
Boxes to the center, please. Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, after four rounds of action, we go to the referees and scorecards. Referee Sean McAvoy scores the contest 39-37 for your winner from Luton, Ollie. Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, the action continues with our next bout of the evening. So please welcome first into the arena to the red corner, Adebowal Silvia dos Santos. Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, the action continues with our next bout of the evening. So please welcome first into the arena to the red corner, Adebowal Silvia dos Santos. Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, please welcome into the arena to the blue corner, Louis O'Doherty! Association with 10-14 promotions, proudly present four rounds of action in the lightweight division. The battle sanctioned by the British Boxing Board of Control, supervisor of ringside referees, our timekeeper of the bell, Mr. Ming Chai, and the referee in charge of the action, scoring the bout, Mr. Lee Avery. So introducing our first boxer, fighting out of the red corner, his official weight on the scale, 437.2 pounds. His official record, 8 victories, 2 coming by way of knockout, 4 defeats. Wearing the green, yellow, blue shorts from Brazil, presenting Avetur Silva dos Santos. His opponent tonight, standing across the ring of boxing out of the blue corner, his official weight on the scale, 137.1 pounds. Tonight, he makes his professional boxing debut wearing the black shorts from Hampstead, Essex, presenting Lou O'Doherty. His official weight on the scale, our referee gives his final instructions. Tonight, he makes his professional boxing debut wearing the black shorts from Hampstead, Essex, presenting Lou O'Doherty.
This should be a good one. Dos Santos is tough as nails, and O'Doherty's having his debut for a good amateur. Sure, he won the ABAs. Let's see how this goes.
They're always trying to make a statement on their debut, aren't they?
Literally, especially with that crowd, he's probably so amped up right now. Big shots. He's got to be careful.
Yeah, he might underestimate Santos, yeah. Trying to make a statement on their debut, aren't they? Yeah, he might underestimate Santos, yeah. It's a big test for his debut, this one.
Yeah, it is. But I mean, it's good he comes to a fight like this. You know, it tests you. You're not just going to have someone that's going to be running around on that. And you're going to let you know straight away what the podium is about.
Yeah.
Someone's going to throw shots back at you. And you've got to defend them and get out of the way of them before you're back. Yeah, it is. But meters good. He comes through a fast. Oh, good shot. You know straight away what the ball is about.
Yeah.
Some of them throw shots back at you. And you've got to defend them right away and throw you back.
Do you know Louis? Have you met Louis?
Yeah, he's down the gym with the ball.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah.
Put that ball down with the ball kind of thing.
You know Louis? Have you met Louis?
Yeah, he's down the gym with the ball.
Santos. Santos got a spiteful hook there, ain't he?
He does. Pace for the whole 4 rounds. Yeah. I don't think neither of them will slow down.
Yeah, he's got good support here.
Yeah, very good.
They're cheering like he's won in the first round. That's good. It must feel good. You have a good support turn, don't you? You must love it. Does it add the pressure on, or does it?
No, it makes it quite hard.
Yeah, yeah, good. Alan, you're not going to be waiting too long. Dev warms the next fight. Got three more rounds of this, yeah.
Good shot there again from the other team.
Don't worry, Alan, you're not going to be waiting too long. Dev warms the
He's
next
just sort
fight.
Of walking Santos down. Got Santos on the back foot.
Got four more rounds. Keeps giving Santos the centre of the ring, really.
Yeah, he kind of gives it away a little bit too much, but it's all experience all around from that.
Yeah,
it's all around from that.
Ross Hooks here.
Yeah, I'm gonna take a fight. seconds. Second round. Last round.
Final round.
A good debut for you know, Louis O'Doherty. Santos is giving him a real test. First round of people to drop. And I think that they're both going for it. One is at the flat.
Yeah, it's a very close fight as well, from what I've seen.
Both men are landing punches. Both men are pushing each other back. But it's a fight, man. It's a fight.
It's a very close fight as well, from what I've seen.
Both men are landing punches. Both men are pushing each other back. But it's a fight, man. It's a fight. That's a good exchange. Good cover there from Lee. Oh, good return. Santos is just going for it. Relentless. Putting everything into all his shots. Louis throwing back. Probably feeling the pace a little bit now, but they're both going for it. That's a good exchange. Good cover there from Lee. Oh, wow. Good return. Santos is just going for it. Relentless. What a fight. What a fight. Putting everything into all his shots.
He needs to get off the ropes.
He does need to get off those ropes. Santos is going that way. Good shot. Good effort from Lee. What a fight. What a fight.
Good fight.
He does need to get off those ropes. Santos is going that way. Good shot. Good effort from Lee.
Ladies and gentlemen, please show these both boxers, a big round of applause for a fantastic bout and shout out to our referee, Every. But ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, after four rounds of action, we go to the referee's
ladies and card. Gentlemen,
our referee, show these both boxers, this is both boxers, not the contest, a 39 for a 7 for your winner, Every.
Louis.
Thank you. for the owner of SirMPU, license plate YK12NTO. That's Yankee Kilo 12 November Tango Oscar. Please go and move your car. The owner of a silver BMW. Please go and move the car. For the owner of a silver BMW. License plate. Ladies and gentlemen, if you own a silver BMW with a license plate Yankee Kilo 12 starting, please go and move your car immediately. The owner of a silver BMW. Please go and move the car. Ladies and gentlemen, if you own a silver BMW with a license plate. Ladies and gentlemen, a big shout out to our fighters here at ringside. The Brighton Rock. Scott Walsh is here this evening. Over my shoulder to the left. 25, 26 heavyweight contests, 17 knockouts coming from those. And Paul Holbin, of ever popular Brighton featherweight, is here today. Shane Willis of ESW Accountants, Shane Willis to ringside. A big thank you as well to our sponsors, Damian Walton of Almelco Technologies. Again, sponsoring this bout means that boxers like Louis and others get a chance and an opportunity to make their debut here. Shane Willis of the ladies and gentlemen, our final bout then of the evening. Please welcome Officer Stadia into the ring to the red corner, Ethan King. Means boxers like Louis and others get a chance and an opportunity to make their debut here. Ladies and gentlemen, a final bout that I saw the light on the night. Please that I passed by the room. Into the ring, to the red corner, Ethan.
I saw the flickering shadows of love on her blind. She was my woman.
And his opponent, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome into the ring and to the blue corner, Devon Miller! And his opponent, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome into the ring and to the blue corner, Devon. The bout sanctioned by the British Boxing Board of Control. Our supervisor here at ringside, Mr. Des Rees. Our timekeeper at the bell, Mr. Nick White. And our referee in charge of the action, he's in shout, Mr. Sean McAvoy. So introducing our first fighter, fighting out of the red corner. He is official weight on the scales, 204.3 pounds. He enters the ring with a professional record, two victories, one coming by way of knockout, and two defeats. Wearing the black, white, and gold shorts from Mountain Ash, Wales, Prezio Air, Ethan. He is official weight on the scales, 204.3 pounds. He enters the
enters the ring with a professional record. Two victories.
And his opponent standing across the ring of boxing out of the blue corner.
His official weight on the scales, 205.4 pounds.
He enters the ring with a professional record.
One victory coming by knockout, one defeat. Wearing the gray, white, gold, and black shorts from Blackheath, London, presenting Devon Miller!
Our referee to give his final instructions.
Professional record, one victory coming by knockout, one defeat. Wearing the grey, white, gold, and black shorts from Blackheath, London, presenting Devon Miller!
Our referee to give his final instructions.
Here we go, Devon Miller.
Final fight.
Devon Miller's ready to play about. Might get the first opportunity of the night. Oh! Ethan King is down. Good shot from Devon Miller.
Oh.
He's going to get shit on him.
He's got it, really.
Good uppercut from Devon Miller.
He's out. He ain't getting up from that.
He ain't getting up, Jim.
Wow. First round.
That was a good shot. That was a good shot. Good body shot. Oh, let's hope Ethan King was okay.
He
ain't getting up, Jim.
Wow, first round.
That was a good shot. That was a good shot.
Wow, he made a statement there, didn't he?
He made a big statement. You know, he's come back with vengeance. He lost his debut, won the next one with the first round KO, and then won this one with the first round KO. So, you know, he's back.
Yeah.
You know, with vengeance, he's got a point to prove.
Yeah, he's like, forget that I lost that first fight. Watch the second.
He made a big statement.
He's up, he's getting
up. He's up now, he's coming back. He's lost his debut, won the next one with the first round KO, and then won this one with the first round KO. So, you know, he's back.
He looked confident as well. When I saw him square off when they faced off earlier,
he's got a point to prove.
Yeah, he's like, forget that I lost that first fight. Watch the second.
He's got a 2-2 record, so. You know, he's up, he's up now, 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 he's up
now, he's up now, he's up now, he's up now, he's up now, he's up now, he's up now,
he's up now, he's up
now,
he's
up now, he's up now, he's up now, he's up now, he's up now, he's up now, he's up now, he's up now, he's up now,
he's up now, he's up now, he's up now, he's up. What, Devon Miller's come and shown. Oh, great night. Thank you guys for tuning in.
Yeah.
Those of you that tuned in live on the stream and are in live in attendance.
That first knockdown when he took a knee, I think, from
we are out. Standing room only.
Lewis Bowers, Denzel Bentley, Del Sajuandani on the music, Wayne Maynard on the cameras.
Great night. Thank you guys for tuning in.
And that's the team.
You heard?
That's the gang. And when we bring out a podcast, we'll let you all know.
We are out.
No, but yeah, thanks to all the sponsors. Thanks to everyone that came through. Well done to all the fighters. Some great fights.
Yeah.
And tune in next month. We'll be back.
June 17th, I believe. And that's the team.
That's the team. Maybe we'll bring out a podcast. We'll let you all know. Yes, you are right.
No, but yeah, thanks to all the sponsors.
Third Saturday of June. Get yourself down here.
Well done to all the fighters.
The only venue left in Canning Town. The only boxing venue left in
Newark. Tune in next month. We'll be back.
Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, at a time of 46 seconds of the first round, your winner by TKO.
Yes, you are right. The only venue left in Canning Town. The only boxing venue left in Newark.
Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, at a time of 46 seconds of the first round, your winner by TKO, Devon Miller!
Every day is a daydream. Everything in my life ain't what it seems. I wake up just to go back to sleep. I act real shallow, but I'm in too deep. And all I care about is sex and violence. Every baseline is my kind of silence. Everybody says that I gotta get a grip, but I let Sonic E give me the slip. Some people think I'm broken, but I just think I'm free. Man, I'm just living my life. There's nothing crazy about me.
Ladies and gentlemen, that does bring us to the end of a fantastic afternoon here at the Peacock Gymnasium for Peacock Promotions and TM14 Promotions. Please, please, please check out the website. We'll be back again next month and we look forward to seeing you again there real soon. So on behalf of all the sponsors and everyone here today, thank you and have a safe journey home. Good night. Fantastic afternoon here at the Peacock Gymnasium for Peacock Promotions and TM14 Promotions. Please check out the website. We will be back again next month and we look forward to seeing you again there real soon. So we have all the sponsors and everyone here today. Thank you. Have a safe journey home. Good night.
I wake up just to go back to sleep. I act no shallow, but I'm in too deep. I know I can't buy this sex.
Yeah, man.
I wake up every day is a daydream. Everything in my life ain't what it seems. I wake up just to go back to sleep. I act real shallow, but I'm in too deep. And all I care about is sex and violence. A heavy baseline is my kind of silence. Anybody says that I gotta get a grip, but I let Sonic E give me the slip. Some people think I'm broken, but I just think I'm free. I wake up, I'm just living my life. I act real shallow, but I'm in too deep. Some people pay for thrills, but I get a pound for free. Man, I'm just living my life. There's no shit that you can't make a scene.
Yeah.